Detail about functions. So whenever we are saying that there is a function, I had already mentioned that there are three important things. First one is rule f, then second one we say that we define a rule from where to where. We define a rule from a set A to set B. Okay. So overall this in together we are defining a function. Okay. So tell me, what is name of this one? F of x. What we will call f of x? Anyone? What is f of x? Function. Simply, yeah, you are saying function of x. So simply, no, I am talking about what we call this one. Just there is a misconception, that's why I told that actually this one is a function. This rule we are calling it function, and when we are writing f of x, this simply it is a value corresponding to f under the function, the value of x under the function f. So we can simply say that it is actually not representing a function, it is representing value of f x under f. Or simply we say that a better word we would like to take, it is representing image of x under f in codomain. So we better word, I think everyone might be aware of image. So we say that it is image of or output image, or you can say in computer language output. Output of what? Output of x under. So never call this f of x, it is a function. It is actually, it is a value of an output under, output of x under f. Okay, under f. So f is the function. Here this, simply this term we will call it a function. So you need to see the difference. When you are saying that f of x, it just become a value. So we never call f of x a function. We just call f is a function, that rule through which x assign a value in b. And what is name of a? Anyone? Just try to answer. You know that. What is name of a? No. This. Domain, nice. So domain, we say that A is the domain of A. What is the beauty of domain of A? Why? What is meaning of domain? One person, just one student, he rightly pointed out. Domain means every element of A, every element of that domain, that set would be engaged or by mapped by F in B. So that means everyness, you have to see when you try to find out domain. So it is also giving a process to how to find domain of a function. So we have to see everyness. Everyness. Simply, we need to put that every element of the domain must be engaged by the function f, and that will find an image in B. So that means simply I would like to point out everyness. I am saying this, that concept, everyness. Now tell me what we call B. Yeah, very nice. Yeah, so everyone know that codomain, rightly pointed out. I have already told that just try to find uniqueness, some uniqueness to identify things. So how you can identify codomain and how you can identify that what do we call it? What is a special thing within Kodomo? What we try to look for all output. Yeah, nice. Yeah, in the code domain, so that output happens to be what? Simply it say output. Simply I will denote it by collection of all output. We will denote it by f of a. What is name of f of a? Definitely it would be a subset of code domain. So that means code domain is B. Subset f of a is a subset of codomain B. Tell me, what is f of a? Okay, we call it range of f, range of the function f. Okay. So simply also you can say that it is image of the domain A. So also you can say that it is image of the domain. If you talk from the image perspective, you can say that it is the image of domain. Domain A under f. So definitely if you change the rule, your domain and range, definitely that would be changed. So always we need to mention, if you are saying it is a range or image of a domain, under what rule? Under rule f. So you have to mention all those things. Everyone aware of all those things, I know that, but you have to make things very systematic so that you won't commit any mistake while attempting problem from calculus. So you need to identify things. Okay. So I discuss most of things regarding function. Same thing, I will highlight it again in detail way, and you will see something more than this. Okay. So coming to outline of today's lecture, first I will discuss about functions, how to define a function, and how the rule is acting over input and getting output. So the concept of input output is very much what we call it related with CSC. Computer science background, so that's where machinery kind of objects, that's where we are putting. Then after that we will talk about inverse of a function, and if time permit then we will go to discuss further concept, like simply we will go to discuss, we will start sequence and series after this. Okay. And we will discuss various criteria regarding sequence series. So coming to function, so as I mentioned that function we have to define very smartly. It is always defined by a rule, and someone is willing to further try to sort out from the Cartesian product or rule or relation. You can see the, you can try to find that as well in high school mathematics, but I won't go in detail. So simply a function is what? It is a rule for transforming any kind of object, any object x, into another object f of x. So that's why I had pointed out here, when you are saying that f of x, it is another object which is transformed version of the primary object x. X you can say that it is the primary object, and f of x is the transform object under the rule f, and that rule we are calling it function. And the object, that primary object, or simply the object with which we start, we are calling it generally input. That means x, that primary object, happens to be input, and whatever outcome we are getting after transforming the after applying the transformation f, the transform object we are calling it output, that falls in the codomain, and the collection of all input, it forms a set, that set we are calling it domain. Okay, so the object we start with, that we are calling it input, or simply primary object, simply also you can say that. So I am talking right now in general sense, and the collection of all those primary object or input, we are calling it domain. So it is very, what we call it, informal definition of function, informal definition of domain, informal definition of input. Similarly, again, what we get back after applying the transformation over the object, what we are getting as a transform object, that we are calling it output, and it comes from some another set. That set we are calling it codomain. And here, if you try to see in the transformation in more detail, then simply we say that f is the rule of transformation and f of x is the result. It is the outcome of the transformation when applied to x. So by applying the transformation rule to x, so simply you can say that f of x, always call it, never try to call it a function. It is actually output or outcome under f to x. When f is transforming x, then we are getting output f of x. So that is the concept. Okay, so this f of x, it would be in different set. That set we are calling it codomain. Now, so this one was informal definition, that as we mentioned about what is function. What is the formal definition of function? So formally we have to come up with some axiomatic approach, that suppose R is a, definitely this set always represents set of all real numbers. So take any two subset of R, then we define a rule F from A to B that assigns a number Y. Remember, assign a number, or you can here call it some number. So sumness also you can call it. Either you call it a number or you can replace it by some number. So this rule assign, this rule f assign some or a number in B for every number or every member of A, such that we see the assignment that this element, it would be equal to, it can be written as y equal to f of x. So this one is one kind of assignment between x and y. So it is not necessary that for every x you will get a definitely it is for being a function, for every x we have to get at least one member. One, for every x at least we have to get one member in order to define a function. Okay, so that's why simply a means at least or some, you can just relate all these. Okay, so it is going like this way. Okay, like this you can. Coming like this way. So if you are starting, suppose this one is x, so there would be a single arrow that we do. Suppose this one is x, this one is y, so that we can call it y equal to f of x. Okay, if you take another number, then it will find again, it will find one assignment number here in this call. This one is A, this one is B, this one is A. So this rule assign a number, some number or a number B for every element in A. So this one is more formal definition, what we call it. Everyone might be aware of that. So one example, suppose we are taking f of x equal to x square. So what is here f? So f is simply what do it transform any number into a square. That means when we do f is what, how we will write it? F we will write it like this way. Okay, f you are writing. So what is the rule f? Here you have to find, we have to see it. It is talking about performing a square. And if I talk about what is the name of this, if further if you talk from the that perspective, what is another name of this x? One I had already told that it is input. What is another name? Anyone? What? Pre-image. Just speak loudly, I'm unable to hear. Pre-image. Fine. Okay. Because it is finding an image in the codomain, so that's a pre-image. No, but pre-image is not looking for better, what we call variable. Then what is x square is also variable.
X is variable, then what is unique thing? You have to, I told that when you are defining some concept, you have to come up with uniqueness. So as I told that how this domain is having uniqueness from B, because in domain we are talking about everyness, and in B we are talking someness, that means assign a number. Okay, someness. So that's where A and B are different. A is falling in domain, B is the what codomain. Same thing, if x is variable, then x square is also variable. So it is not just any other. Have you heard that concept? Would be very much essential in understanding further in differentiability and other kind of stuff. Any other have you heard? Have you heard or not? So it is, those notes are very helpful in order to understand function in detail. So let me write it little bit in what spacious. So what is it? Have you heard any another name? No, better name. What? What? Unable to listen you. Just speak loudly. Input I had already mentioned here. No? You can see the input I had already mentioned. So input again, that one is very specific. General, I am trying to come up with general name. So here we call gen argument here. I was willing to listen this answer. Generally we call it argument. Argument is a very really interesting name. So what is happening that when we say that, we just identified that here function is what we are performing, a squaring of any real number, any number, every real. When we say that real number domain, we are fixing the domain. Okay, so we are performing a squaring of any number. Okay, so here what is the argument? Argument is coming is a real number. So this x, we can say that it argument, it is one argument. So in the function, once we are putting argument, so here we are putting argument, and hence we are getting here output. So always remember that you can always call it argument. Later you will see that derivative representation as well, dot representation or dash representation. So if it is coming like this way, then easily you can see that, you can understand that what does it talk about. It is talking about x is the function of t, and we are differentiating this x with respect to t. So if nothing is mentioned here, by default you have to assume that x is a function of t and t is the argument. You need to understand, we are taking this dot is talking about derivative. This derivative we have taken with respect to argument, that independent variable. So later we can call another name, that you can, when you are calling it variable, call it independent variable. So another name, independent variable, argument and independent variable, both are same. Okay, but again argument will have more general thing. So you can call it here independent variable. That is the concept. Okay, so it is assumed that the here, if you try to talk about this function, if you talk about f is the rule that transform any number into it a square, then it is always possible to perform a squaring of any real number, and hence we can say that one candidate of being domain of this function, it would be real number. And now if you talk about if you are squaring a real number, then again you are getting what, real number. So codomain would be also real number. Okay, so we can square any real number and get a real number back. Like if you take 2, it is a real number, then if you are squaring 2, then what you will get? 4. What does it mean? Simply it says that the squaring function has transformed 2 into 4. So it is meaning of function. Now next question is coming that we have to find domain and range of a function. Okay, how to find? So again we are defining, so it is very much essential to understand what is the domain. Domain, so domain is always decided by the underlying function, underlying rule, what, how we have defined. So I am taking one more function, that h of x. Here h of x is counting number of legs x is having. number of legs x is having. So simply, what would be candidate of domain here? Anyone? Which kind of object is having legs? Animal. So simply animal will come. So here domain, here easily see that set of all domain will animals will fall in the domain of this function. So that's way we say that domain of this function h is what? Set of all animals. Okay, now suppose if you are saying that taking a member of from that domain horse. So horse, how many legs horse is having? 4. So h of horse we are saying it 4. How many legs and one end is having? 6, or depends upon what kind of generally it may happen 6. If you take a salmon fish, how many legs salmon fish is having? No legs there, 0. So you have to just from the way function is defined, you have to come up with the domain. Okay. So based on the once we are having idea of domain, we can come up with codomain. So first essential thing is that come up with rule. This is the rule. Second one is after seeing the rule, visualizing rule, you have to find out what is the domain. After that, once you are having idea of domain, then you have to see that how the rule is transforming the domain, and after transformation what kind of output you are getting. That one is leading towards codomain, and here codomain would be, so we talk counting number of legs. So legs can't be in negative number, so it would be at most, at least it would be 0, otherwise it will legs can't be 1.5 or something fraction, also it can't be. So it would be always non-negative integer. So your domain would be non-negative integers. It is non-negative integers. Generally we denote it by z plus union including 0. Okay. All another name, whole number. We denote it by whole number also, you could call whole number. Generally that count start with 0 to it will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So also domain is simply whole number. Since animal don't have negative or fractional kind of legs, so that's where codomain would be non-negative integers. Now if I'm asking take x equal to 2, then simply you will say that 2 is what? It is a real number, it is not an animal. So definitely 2 can't have legs. 2 can't be, first 2 can't be in the domain of h, and hence simply we will say that h of 2, it is not defined. It is not defined. Why? Because 2 is not in, it is not in the domain of the rule f. So that's why h of 2 is not defined. Likewise, someone is asking question, what is h of chair? Then your answer would be here 4. That means chair can have at most 4 legs. Okay, that you observe that. But remember that domain we have taken it as an animal, collection of all animals. The chair is not an animal. So again, this concept is not defined. It is undefined. In one, so that's way here the output you have to decide based on highly dependency. So it always exhibit the dependency over the domain. So that's way whatever value here in codomain we will come it, and that we will term as a dependent variable, and whatever value we observe in domain that we represent in independent, that value is coming in independent way. So dependency and independency, you can see it like this way. So next question is that if you talk about what is codomain, it is the set of possible output, while what would be the range, it would be the set of actual output. So here you can see the difference between codomain and range. So there is one more term through which you can comment over that. Codomain is your set of all possible outcome, and range is actual outcome, what you are getting through the rule h. So set of all actual is coming. So three most possible common possibilities are there in order to find. First, we are trying to find domain. We are trying to first find domain, codomain, and range. It would be automatically you will get to know after once you are having idea of a domain. So there are three important rule, important possibility through which you can easily find domain of a function. What are those important? Or simply you can say that these are the elementary rule through which you can find domain of a function. And because you need to start from somewhere else. If you want to find domain, so a starting point must be there. So you have to observe the function, given function in a very close way and try to look it first that if there is a denominator, then denominator of fraction it count to be zero because 1/0 is not a number. Denominator count to be zero. So if you try to see a function, if you are having a function, then we try to just find those value for which denominator is vanishing. So we have to remove up from the set. From the that means take a largest possible set as a largest possible set, and from there just keep on do selectivity. So first one is saying that denominator count to be zero. Second, say that you can't take a square root of a negative number. That means if a square root is involved there, so these are very simple kind. One is one by x or one by one expression, x count to be zero. Here you put like this way. Another, you are saying that if you are have, there is an involvement of a square root with some argument, so call it some argument. Remember that I am saying it here argument. I am not saying that input. Okay, argument. Argument is more general than input. Okay, so here argument must be what greater than equal to zero. It must be non-negative number. That means argument must be greater than equal to zero. Okay. Now third one. There is third one. Third one. What does it say? If there is an involvement of a logarithmic function, an argument of logarithmic function is always greater than zero. That means argument of a logarithmic function neither can be a negative number nor can be a zero. So argument of a logarithmic function, it would be always greater than zero. Must means it would be always positive. So just remember three basic rule in order to find domain of a function. So I am taking one example here, and we'll try to see whether that given example is a function. So we are defining a function by rule, and we are getting output like this: f of x equal to logarithmic of the x plus 8 times a square root of 26 minus twice of x divided by x minus 2 x plus 19. So just apply the all those three concept here and try to look it here. So look for this logarithmic concept. We know that a logarithmic is defined with only positive argument. Remember that here it is a local, very local in sense. When we are talking about logarithmic function here, what is the argument of this logarithmic function? It is x. So this argument must be greater than zero. So simply, what does it, if you try to see here the logarithmic involved here, what is the argument of this logarithmic function? Anyone? What is the argument? Yeah, very very nice. X plus 8. Don't try to call it x only. So it would be here because it is, I always say that it is a very localized concept. So you have to look what kind of expression is there. From there, you have to come up with argument. So that's why argument is a very generic in nature. So you have to talk in localized sense. Okay. So here in this involved logarithmic function, x plus 8 is the argument. So that argument must be a positive quantity. So it is one. It is just one inequality. So we have to add additive inverse of 8 both sides, and after simplifying, what we are getting? We are getting x must be between minus 8 to infinity. X must be greater than minus 8, and we can put in the interval form. Okay, so it is just one. There are various terms here. Second term, that we know that a square root function is defined only for non-negative argument. Okay, that's why if you try to look into here, there is a square function. And what is the argument of this? What is the argument? 26 minus twice of x. So here you have to take a condition that this in the function involve 26, the argument of square root is 26 minus 2x, it must be greater than or equal to 0. So you are getting an inequality. So this inequality you can solve it using order property. So here solve it. So simply what you do, take multiply with negative sign and just add 26 both hand side. Then what you will observe that twice of x would be less than equal to 26. Further what you do, you divide, multiply 1 by 2 both sides. So from here what you will observe, x is less than equal to 13. All you are performing through order property. That's why for this part we observe that x is defined for what, minus defined this argument, only this part is defined in minus infinity to up to 13, including 13 as well. Now there are two more terms involved in the function. So one is x minus 2. So it is coming, so when it is coming in denominator, definitely this quantity can't be 0. So that means x minus 2 can't be 0. What does it say? Simply x can't be 2. Likewise, x can't be, x plus 19 can't be 0. That means x can't be negative 19. Okay, so what is happening, that this function rule is defined by what, defined by four functions. So all these functions are come in together. So we are talking about joint occurrence of all these functions. So that's way, so domain of f would be what? That would be joint domain of this one. Joint, remember that, joint domain of this one. So what is the joint domain of this one? So just to try to see in the line scheme, that looks always very good. So here first one is talking about that this logarithmic function saying that x must be between here you can put it in this point would be 0 minus 8, it would be here, and there is a point 13, 13 would be here, we have pointed out. So this first condition say that x lies between minus infinity to minus 8 to infinity. Second condition, it says that x lies between 13 to minus infinity. So 13 to minus infinity, it is coming like this way. So here 2, so it will go something like this. And third, there is a third condition, that one is coming from denominator, x can't be 2. So there is a hole in 2, that means gap in 2, there is a gap in 2, 2 can't be here, and x also can't be negative 19. So negative 19, it would be somewhere here. So there is a gap in at the place negative 19. Okay, so just we try to find what is the intersected region, that common region for which all these functions are defined. So these are the common region. So simply we can say that what is the domain of this function. Simply we can say that domain of this function is the value x is taking between minus 8 to 13, including 13 and excluding 2. There is a, we don't exclude, in between the interval we don't include 2, we are excluding 2. So this is the domain of f. So we are having domain of f. Okay, now next we will talk about whether the given rule is a function or not. So I should talk this first. So there is a vertical test through which we can say that if you are able to plot the graph of the function, then geometrically we can perform a vertical line test, and if vertical line is intersecting the graph of the function at adjective once or never, then we can say that the given function is what, the given rule is defining a function, otherwise it would be not a function. So vertical rule, so like if you take a circle, then through vertical rule you will see that there are various horizontal line which intersect more than once. So simply it is not a function through vertical line test. And if you put here, you can make a function if there are various what intersecting point with respect to that origin, vertical line test, then what you do, you can introduce branches. So branch wise, you can define convert circle as a function. So take this one is the upper branch. If you take just this upper branch, then this one is one function. You can denote it by F1. You have to change the name. Branch wise, you have to change the name. If you take another branch, okay, I am giving arrow. You can denote it in this one by F2. So this one is denoting another function. So if there is a relation which is not a function due to this vertical line test, then always we can convert that relation into a what we call function by using branch wise. It is a function. So definitely in aggregate, if F1 and F2 you are taking together, it is a multivalued function. It is a multivalued function. Because origin line, vertical line is cutting this relation more at two places in few occasion. So that's why it is a multivalued function. But when people are saying that a function simply means single valued function. It is not like that multivalued function is not defined. When people are saying that function, then simply we are dealing with single valued function. Function means single valued function. So always we discuss about single valued function, and relation it may be multi valued or single valued. So if there is a multi valued relation, we have to single it out through branch wise. So and then we will get a single valued function. So in the function, simply you can say that single valued is missing, single valued function, or this single function is single valued function. That is the concept. So you can always come up with a single valued function from multivalued function through branch wise approach. So branch is very essential. We'll discuss later when we'll discuss integration and other kind of things. So that time I will discuss various concept of branch approach. Okay, I will take further example of functions, and which are functions and few would be not a function. Like we are taking one example, x equal to y square minus 2 twice of y plus 5. So tell me whether it is a function or not through vertical line test. Who would like to answer? Y square minus twice of y, it is not function. Why? Okay, I am unable to visualize that. Let me visualize it first. So that's why I am doing little bit manipulation here. So first do this manipulation, after that draw the graph. Plotting graph is very easy right now. You don't need calculus. Why? Because it is directly coming from that analytical geometry, that coordinate geometry what you have already gone through plus 2. So from there easily you can draw the plot of this one. Y minus 1 whole square plus 4. 1 we have taken it here, so it would be very fine. So if you are representing this one in terms of like this way, so easily you can write it as a parabola. And what is the parabola? Your axis would be axis of parabola, it would be horizontal with respect to x axis. Okay, and what is the center? Where would be center? It's coming something like that. So if you talk about axis of this one, so always do plotting if you are able to do plotting. So this line is y equal to 1. This point is what is the name of this point? 0, 0, 1. Letter 4 is, what is meaning of 4? Then, so this one is plot of what? It is plot of just not actual function. It is plot of y minus 1 whole square. After that, what do you do? What kind of shifting you observe here? What does it this four talking about? You people are using very complicated words. Simply just say that it is just a translation. You're translating here by amount four. What is happening? You are translating. So whether it is a what backward translation or forward? That means it is positive. So the direction of positive x. Okay. So that you would like to see. So just that's a way break things in very simple way. Mathematics is very simple, just you have to follow the rules. Don't just apply a Lebesgue approach. So this point would be what? Okay, 4, 1. Like, why? Because we always take x value first, so that's it. Okay, so now every picture is clear to you. You don't need calculus to draw the graph of this this given relation. Now you apply vertical test here. Definitely here this vertical line is cutting the graph at two places, so it is not a function. That means not a singular function. So if you go branch wise, one branch you take like this way, denoted by f1, and you take another branch like this way, denoted by f2. So it is a branch wise, it is a branch wise function. There are two branches, but in together it is not a function. So you have to go for branch wise. It is a two valued function. Simply you can say it is a two valued function, that is a multi valued function, but it is not a single valued function. Branch wise it is a function. Okay, so that's why we have to. Yes. Okay, I am going to just end this class. In next